Click on the subscribe button to subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
When you take methodology into consideration, methodology plays an important role in getting the success in all teacher recruitment test related. Methodology acts the main role as it is with the full of concepts and conceptual understanding. And how the concepts are utilized in the daily life, that is regarding the application. And the concepts, how we have to remember, and all the educationists related to the concepts and their definitions, all these things will come across. We have several chapters in this. First of all, we will be knowing the importance of methodology questions in getting the success. The questions are of different types. If you see the old papers, even before 2008 like that, all the TET and DSC papers have many direct questions, or we can name them as knowledge questions. The knowledge questions are directly prepared from the textbook, whatever prescribed for you. That may be the academy book or any other publications. But definitely we are following the academy book as the main guidance for our preparation. The direct questions or knowledge questions are given from the academy book or any other related book directly. But the application questions are different. For example, if there is a question from the social studies methodology, the social studies methodology deals with the following, like that they will be giving the question. Means the methodology taught us how to teach social studies or how to teach the social relations with the human beings, like that they will be teaching. This type of direct questions nowadays they are not giving. The methodology concept they will be giving in the form of application, which is very essential for a social studies teacher. They may give the application question in this way. If Anil wanted to become a social studies teacher, which of the following is very essential for him? Like that they will be giving. The options they may give: the knowledge of experimentation, or the knowledge of numbers, or the art of drawing, or the nature of roaming to different places or visiting different places, like that they may give the options. Here we will be selecting the interest of visiting different places, like that for a social studies teacher it is very, very essential. So in this way they will give the application questions, how the concepts are utilized in the incident. They will be giving one incident. Here we have taken Anil as the person and who is showing interest to become the social studies teacher, that is incident. So like that, questions which you are preparing for this methodology, they must be application related And the concepts are involved in the application, how we are utilizing it in our daily life. Based on that, they will be giving many more questions. Secondly, we have to concentrate on reading the questions correctly, because sometimes they will give the concepts in the negative way. For example, which is not related to the understanding objective in the education system, like that they will be giving. So here in this question, we can observe one particular word which is called as not. So here, if there is a not or no, or not related or unrelated, like that negative sense in the question, we have to read it correctly. If you understand it as a positive, through the positive sense, you will be getting many options in this. But you will be mistaken if you don't read this particular not or no sense in this question. That's why we must be very careful with this, with such questions. Sometimes they will ask the questions based on the order of the sequence or sequential order. That may be related to the steps in the cognitive domain, in the objectives and specifications, or steps in the affective domain or psychomotor domain, or steps in the heuristic method in science, steps in the inductive and deductive methods in the mathematics, like that they will be asking, or storytelling method in social studies. Based on these steps, they may ask questions. You have to learn these steps in the particular order, in the hierarchical way, which is the lowest order, which is the highest order. Like this, they may ask questions. So you must be aware of all these types of questions before going to the examinations. We have to have enough practice of collecting all the model papers, and by selecting questions even from the old papers. First of all, you have to understand the pattern of the questions and the difficulty level of the questions. If you have such preparation, it is very easy to go through these tests and get a very good job. Teaching profession is a very noble profession, which is away from all types of corruptions, which is having power of changing the generations. That's why I can congratulate you for opting such a good profession in future. As we go through the syllabus for methodology for SGT, all methodologies are included. We are teaching all these methodologies on one span, because all the methodologies are interrelated, and there are so many the chapters which are going to deal with, they are having coincidence. Just like that, we have the first chapter as the nature and scope of different subjects. That may be the nature and scope of mathematics, nature and scope of science, nature and scope of social studies. They may be varied based on the definitions, based on the nature of the subjects, based on the scope of the subjects. But when you go through these chapters, the other chapters like objectives and specifications or methods of teaching, we can see there are so many things which are same in all the methodologies. That's why if you are perfect in one methodology or topics, though we are dealing all the methodologies at one stretch, we'll be learning the concepts which are same in all methodologies. Wherever difference is there, we'll be noting them down. So first, I am going through the first chapter, the try methods, the nature and scope. I am stopping here because nature and scope related to different subjects we will be dealing in this. First of all, if I take mathematics, the nature and scope, in this introductory part we can say the science and technology is depending on mathematical knowledge. Mathematics is the unique subject, though there is a feeling in the society that mathematics is a difficult subject, but the teachers, if they teach by using the proper way of teaching mathematics, by using the teaching learning material, it is as easy as other subjects. So each and every subject demands the knowledge of the mathematics. On the part of the more people, mathematics has been with us for more than 5,000 years. That was the history of the mathematics we can see. Mathematics is with us more than 5,000 years. Mathematical discovery and the invention has accelerated amazingly. The development of the mathematics is going very fast and fast. And so many theories are coming, and the new theories are replacing the old theories. And so much development we can see in the present days in the mathematics we can see. Though the theories of 2000 years ago, they seems to be old, but they are still valid as on date we can see. So mathematics knowledge is very, very essential to see or to understand almost all the subjects. They are a part in even other subjects. Even they have the correlation with other subjects we can see in this. In this mathematics, meaning and definitions, if you see, mathematics is that it is called the science of numbers. The main meaning of the mathematics is it's a science because it's a systematic study. Science in the sense, not the biological science or physical science, but it's a science means systematic study. So mathematics is a systematic study of numbers and space, or the science of quantity or measurement. So these are all included in the mathematics. And the spatial relations, systematized, organized subject, we can say that mathematics is. It's just like a branch of science, we can say. It deals with quantitative and qualitative facts, relationships, as well as the problems. Mathematics, there is a problem solving discipline, we can see. There is a problem and we'll be getting the solution at the end. Using different methods we can see. That's what we are going to see. At the same time, it may be treated as the logical study of shapes. And we can see the arrangement and the quantity also. The geometric, one branch of mathematics, here we can see the shapes and the areas and the formulae which are included to know the different concepts we can understand. So in this concept, we can see the mathematics, a few definitions were given on mathematics. There is a meaning of mathematics, methanen, which is a Greek word, which means a simple technique. It is a simple technique or micro technique. At the same time, it is also has a meaning that is an art. Mathematics is an art. So here we can see some definitions given by different mathematicians or the educationists. Comte defined mathematics as the science of indirect measurement. It's a systematic study which shows us the indirect measurement, not the direct measurement, not taking a scale and measuring the length. Not only that, sometimes we'll be using the formula and knowing the area or the circumference. And all these things indirectly we can see. That is the definition given by Comte. According to Kant, mathematics is the indispensable instrument of all physical researches. You take any type of research that may be in any subject, without the mathematical principle or without the numbers, the knowledge of numbers, we cannot present any such type of research report. For all researchers, mathematics is the basic subject or discipline we can see. So just like that, we can see other definitions like Gauss. He stated that mathematics is the queen of all sciences. What a nice definition he has given. Mathematics is queen of all sciences, and arithmetic is the queen of all mathematics. Arithmetic is the basic thing in the mathematics, which may be treated as the queen of all mathematics they have given. So mathematics importance can be explained by Gauss in this way. Just like that, Roger Bacon he said that mathematics is the gateway and key to all sciences. You know the involvement of mathematics in physics. Physics is almost just like the mathematics, with the problems and so many calculations in it. Without knowledge of mathematics, it's very difficult to teach chemistry even. The formulae and the molecular weight and molecular numbers of the elements and the weights, if you see, in such a cases, in many ways in chemistry, mathematics may be the useful subject which is to be involved in this. That's why we can say it is key to all the sciences, we can say, even in the social sciences. And according to the Lindsay, mathematics is the language of physical sciences they have given. As I said, that the importance of mathematics in the physical sciences. So it is treated as the queen of all sciences just because of that. Based on these definitions, we can confirm our decision or our idea that mathematics is really the queen of all subjects like that. At the same time, we can see the marvelous language was created by the mind of man. This is another means good word they said about the mathematics. Just like that, Locke stated that mathematics is a way to settle in the mind of a habit of reasoning. Mathematics asks why it happened like that, what may be the reason like that, why this answer is coming like this, why that formula is suitable for this, for the solution. Is there any other formula which can satisfy to get the same result? In such a cases, every time the mathematics demands for the reasoning like that, Locke has given his definition. Marshall B. Stone, he said that mathematics is the study of abstract system, they have mentioned. Abstract system. It's not concrete. We can see in this system, the mathematics plays very, very important role to create an abstract system like that, he has given his definition.